Hey my friends, welcome back. Yeah, as you can see into this video, we do something different. We're gonna paint a still life.
Yeah, I'm grabbing a set of brushes here, as you can see. Pre-mix the colors. See the colors on the left side here. I'm using here a 40 by 80 centimeter canvas on a swatcher frame, where I did the pre-sketch, as you can see here. Kind of larger than life, real fruit, more or less. Yeah, and I'm kind of using this first layer of color in some areas as the final layer of color. So I'm really carefully trying to put on the colors very evenly and very thick, kind of. Bit of a time lapse.
Perhaps you might also like to see this video here in a full-time version on my Patreon. Link is somewhere down below here. Where we do this in-detail painting here in a version over 6 hours of pure painting. Make sure you check it out.
So, you've seen that it's basically a very simple and straightforward process of applying the colors in a very simple way. Kind of rough, shaping the fruits, giving in the shape, the rough color, more or less. In some areas I have to rework the whole thing. In most of the areas, in some areas I don't have to rework it again. The lemon itself was a bit more tricky. I had to also readjust in the first pass, more or less, already some of the areas. It looks very, it already has some shape and some size and some form, but not really finished, at least not the main lemon center part here. The other one on the right side here, where we have the shadow kind of hiding the inner part of the lemon, is kind of, more or less finished. And the tangerine here is also built up in a very detailed way already in this stage here. I mean, not very extremely detailed, but I already tried to really get it done so that I don't have to rework the whole thing again. I will later on go back and add some more details to it to make it look just even more realistic. But the base principle here is to get in the rough size, shape, color in the first place with just one pass of the first layer of color. Also note that we have kind of this bluish purplishy color in the shadow areas, and I think this really helps to getting this really nice contrast between the very light areas that we have on the left side and this cool color on the right side. Also note that the tangerine basically it's just emerging a little bit from this very dark color. We have this tangerine is a bit of a warmer color, a bit of a lighter one, but not extremely, so that we also kind of have this tangerine kind of melting into the blue background that we use here. And I'm also using just one layer of color for the table where the fruits rest on. And here you see how I'm kind of intermixing those colors, kind of wet and wet, more or less. It's a very straightforward process. Going into this bluish, purplish color on the right side, and having the table on the left side kind of switching its color to this bluish color here in a very even way, more or less. Trying to really blend those areas here. The background, as you can see here, I'm using here a lot of the white of the canvas. I'm applying the color in some areas, this reddish color, very thin. It's not a second set of brushes that I'm gonna use for the final layer. I had to let this painting sit for, I think, 10 days or so to make sure it's really completely bone dry. And then I go back and reuse the color that I mixed for the first layer of color and just readjust those colors here and there. You can see here, just adding some darker colors on this leaf here to kind of flesh it out even more, to make it more 3D, give it more details, kind of also reshape the leaf itself. And it still amazes me how easy and how quick you actually can really build up details on a leaf like this here without having to rework the whole thing again. I'm of course using different brushes here, as you can see here. A very small round brush for the very fine details. Like here, I'm adding these kind of the highlights on this part of the leaf. And again, it's a really, a very straight and very easy process of just adding some more color here and there, reshaping it a bit, adding some bits and pieces here and there to really enter very quickly with a very nice looking leaf. Adding some details on the trunk of this tangerine here. Also getting back with a very small brush, adding even more details, even more light that's coming in from the left side. And the same basically goes for this tangerine in the back. by just adding some lighter orangey color, a very light one, to indicate those little, I don't know how the English word is, this pattern that these tangerines have when they reflect the light. And this is basically all that you need in this area here. The lemon here, the center, the main figure of this painting here, was quite a bit more work. I'm adding the, I don't even know how they are called, these detail parts in the outer part. With the dry brush technique, using just a little bit of color on the brush, also readjusting those little bits and pieces here to make sure that they don't look too similar all over the place. Adding the center hole, I don't know how it's called, part of this lemon here. Bit darker on the upper and left side and a bit lighter on the right side. And I'm first also trying to give it the little cakes of this lemon just a bit more shape, a bit more volume, a bit more contrast, a bit more 3D effect. And then I'm starting to build up those little details that we have here, those whitish or lines between those cake pieces here. And then the very most important part here are those reflections. I mean, I cut this lemon open just before I started to paint, before I made those photos as a reference. And to really make the lemon up here wet, you need to add those very crisp reflections here. Only then it really starts to look a bit moist. And without those details, it would look off and wrong and simply not like a lemon. Yeah, you of course also have to place them basically where the light is bouncing off into the viewer's eye. Very important. So it's difficult, I think, for a newbie painter. Therefore, you should really rely on your reference photo to really make sure that you don't mess this up. So and finally, we start to rework, add some details to the open tangerine here. And as we spend, yeah, quite a few, yeah, quite some time on the first layer, there's not too much that you that I had to do to make it really look even more realistic, even better. I just adding some darker colors in the center part here. Then I'm kind of reshaping some areas, adding some more detailed parts like this here. And again, it's just the dry brush technique. I'm using a bit of color and let this color fade out into the already existing color we put on before. On the area where the light hits, we need some thicker layer of color. And I'm kind of reshaping this whitish skin above the flesh of this tangerine in some areas. You see, it doesn't take too much to really add volume to it, and add also those shadow parts. Very important, I think, beneath this skin, more or less. And it didn't took that long to really end up with a apparently pretty detailed tangerine, but actually there are not a ton of details in there. And then I again reshaped the shadow areas of this tangerine in the left side here by just again adding some darker color. And this is now the finished painting.
So that's about it for today. I hope you had some fun painting with me, and I hope to see you next time again. Bye!